improved West Virginia defense. And this is Trent Guy. He had the return of the punt for a touchdown a year ago against the Mountaineers, but excellent coverage. Flying down is Charles Pugh, and the Cardinals will start at about their own 15-yard line. Braun decided to come back for his senior year. He told us no regrets, even though the team goals for the Cardinals will not be met. He has played well, and he showed scouts what he's about.
And I think you can learn a lot more about a guy when he's down and the adversity that he's had to overcome this year to keep this football team alive.
He's shown his leadership throughout this whole thing, and he's still, his numbers don't fade at all. And he picks it up, actually, and it's on his shoulders tonight to drive this team up and down the field and keep up with West Virginia.
Crowd on its feet and roaring in the first play of the game for the Cardinals. It's a play-action fake. Brom fires near side, a very short completion, and fighting up toward the first down marker is Gary Barnage, the tight end, making his 42nd catch of the season. It's a team effort to introduce you to the Louisville offense tonight.
Starting up front with our Hogs, we have our center, Eric Woody the Woodpecker Wood.
For the Cardinals, it's a definition of a fast-break offense. Quarterback Brian Brom provides a give, and the most underrated wide receiver in the country, Harry Douglas, provides a go.
Rick Pitino's been very supportive of Craig Thorpe and his struggles in his first season. They do pick up the first down, and now it's Brock Bolin powering ahead. So Bolin, part of that running back rotation, as basketball coach Bob Huggins gets equal time to introduce you to the defense.
Anchoring the defensive line is big Keelan Dykes and sack leader Johnny Dingle. And from my hometown of Morgantown, at linebacker Mark Magro. Defensive backs are led by Ryan Monday and Eric Wicks.
Only allowing 262 yards, but Louisville, a couple of quality plays in the early going here. Sets up a second and three. Braun, pressure up the middle, fires, incomplete. He was trying to find his top target, Harry Douglas, but good pressure from Dykes and Dingle.
Jeff Castile, defensive coordinator at West Virginia, really wants to find a way to force Braun to move his feet in the pocket. And if they can put pressure with four up front, then they'll have a good night defensively.
Yeah, the trick is, out of that defense, 3-3-5, where's the extra rusher coming from? And from an offensive standpoint, picking up those guys, it's hard to decipher sometimes the looks.
Brom's been pretty well protected, only sacked 14 times this season. Third and three. They hand it to Bolin, who's tripped up across the 35. I don't think they're going to give him yardage on the spot. Morty Ivy, the linebacker, with the tackle. They'll be short. They're calling for a measurement that didn't really seem necessary.
It was an encouraging beginning to this drive. Nice plays. The one running play on a cutback was very well blocked.
They've had trouble running the ball the last few games, guys. That's made it harder for Brom. They've had under 400 yards total offense in back-to-back games against Connecticut and Pittsburgh. That's the first time that it happened under Brom. And one of the reasons that they're not running it well, and they didn't get it that time.
There you go. They're not running it real well. They're not having great vision by their backs. Offensive line's not bad. Watching them on tape, watching them play, they do a pretty nice, good job. But the backs, at times, not really using their eyes and their vision to find the holes.
Corey Getchy on to punt. This is Vaughn Rivers, the dangerous returner for the Mountaineers. Who'll win the special teams battle tonight? Edge went to the Cardinals in last year's meeting, and that was important in their home field victory. Rivers, 12.1. Very respectable average. Mountaineers peel back, try to set up a return. Pretty good kick from Getchy. And Rivers hammered, hit instantly. And West Virginia will set up inside their 20-yard line as Pat White brings the offense out for the first time tonight. White's been doing the majority of the running as well as the throwing. They haven't had as many touches for Slayton, and White's been active. That's what the defense has been giving them.
That's right, because the defense, they're going to take the ball out of one of the quarterback or the pitchback's hands, and you know they're thinking that maybe defensively you would rather have Pat White running it, and he's done a nice job with it on the ground.
I think the stat that stands out there is 70% passing the ball this year. He's been exceptional in both categories.
Run for 656 as well, 6.8 per rushing attempt. You see Steve Slayton, White's buddy, lined up to his right. And it's a throw too high for Darius Raynon. And Huggins, like Rodriguez, a West Virginia alum, back with the offense.
Point guard of the offense is Pat White. Behind him, Steve Slayton, a guy I'd love to have on the front of the press. And Owen Schmidt, a big, tough guy, could definitely guard the post. Paving the way for them up front is Ryan Stanchek and Greg Isdan.
Second and 10 after the incompletion. Owen Schmidt and Slayton change positions. This is Slayton. Flag flies after a short loss on the play. Slayton hasn't had the kind of stats he had a year ago. And a chop block called on the Mountaineers. That came from left field, that flag.
You don't see that very often, though, and that's one of those that coaches really watch and try to stress to the ref before the game, watch out for it.
Illegal block, roll the waist. Number 83 on the offense. Penalty is half the distance to the goal from the line of scrimmage. Repeat the down.
They got the receiver, Tito Gonzalez. And they'll move the ball back inside the 10.
Louisville committed 9 guys to the run there. It was no free safety in the middle of the field. Everyone up near the line of scrimmage. They're going to force Pat White to throw the football.
There's a penalty.
Should be an
screen.
Outside in block. Yep. Coming from outside in, you cannot go below the waist.
Second and 19. Stays in the pocket, throws downfield. Raynon battling for the football, intercepted. Intercepted by Deion Palmer. So they test the Cardinals deep with their top receiver, Raynon, but Deion Palmer with his first pick of the season.
Well, Louisville decided to go with the nickel package to start this football game, and they really wanted to come up and force the issue to see if they couldn't get a throw down the field. And then a great job of Palmer of taking the football out of the air.
Palmer was just one-on-one all the way down the field. No safety help. Gets his head around to find the football. Pretty Ooh. Amazing catch.
Wait a second.
Because
did
he turned his head
did the ball hit
at the last second.
Did it hit the ground, though?
He didn't catch the ball cleanly, but I don't know if it hit the
there
ground up.
Wait a second. Here come the officials now. Just before the Cardinals could snap the ball, which would have taken the replay out of play. Hey, we'll take a look at this.
We got to get Fowler a red flag up here.
Well, I'm late to the field. I mean, the guy.
Watch the ball carefully.
Yeah, that's ground. That's not an interception.
That would be a little help from the ground, from the green stuff.
Louisville know it. They ran out there quickly. And whenever you do that, it just seems like the officials are going to blow the whistle just on principle. Well, wait a second. Not so fast, my friends.
Sending up that flare that something's going on.
But, you know, the strategy, though, of Louisville's defense to come out in this game, you're going to be up bunched in the box, but having an extra defensive back there in case Pat White throws the ball down the field, that ball clearly bounces on the grass.
I don't know. We've been wrong before trying to judge what the replay officials would do on a Thursday night. This is the better angle here. Yeah, and it does appear clearly they hit the ground.
Well, we know what we see.
We're always clear up here. We doesn't always mesh with the booth next door.
Yeah, it's leather.
If the call is overturned, it'll be third and 19 for the Mountaineers, still back inside their 10.
Again, though, two out of those three first offensive plays for West Virginia, the Louisville defense had no safety in the middle of the field. They're taking their chances with the speed of the West Virginia receivers.
They're inviting the throw. They feel like with that extra back there that they can match up and try to take some opportunities away from Pat White.
Here you see Palmer. He's the senior from Thompson,
review,
Georgia.
The ruling on the field is reversed. The ball hit the ground. There's an incomplete pass. It will be third down at the 9-yard line.
So what would have been Pat White's third interception of the season is nullified. They almost got away with it, but just before they ran that offensive play, the whistle.
Nice night here. All yellow, gold,
gold rush.
What's your verdict on the all yellow or all gold uniforms? A little bright for you?
It's there. It's loud.
You know, Rodriguez has a group called the 12 Apostles. It's a kind of a player's council, and he always asks them, what do you guys want to wear? And they said, let's go all gold for this one. And Louisville had the blackout, their crowd, a year ago in the meeting. So, 3rd and 19. Empty backfield, 5 receivers for White. He dumps it off short. This is Slayton. And a short game. Slayton's good at making guys miss, but he would have had to make 4 or 5 miss to get that first down. Malik Jackson, Woodney Turin on the stop.
Nice start by Louisville's defense just to get them off the field. You know, this is every series that Louisville's defense can go out and force a punt is a bonus for Brian Brown.
That's a win. We're getting the ball back. We're getting the ball back to our offense and keeping their offense on the sideline.
The illegal block, of course, the key play in that series. And here comes Pat McAfee, the junior punter, who also does the place kicking and the kicking off. And back deep is Trent Gry. Guy took that punt back for a touchdown. 40 yards in last year's meeting. Rugby punt from McAfee, who booms this one out of bounds. That's taken just inbounds by Guy, who tries to get the corner. And what a job by McAfee and the coverage team. Wow. Number 40 does his job. And not very good field position for Brahm and the Cardinals when you come back. From the Ville, Anthony Allen, who's been struggling lately, is the tailback. Brahm fakes it to him on first down, fires complete. And we expect this guy to be very busy tonight. Harry Douglas, the senior. The guy who's caught now 158 passes in his career, 56 on the season. That went good for 17 yards. Douglas has had a great year, Doug. You saw that tape today.
Watching some film on him today, and his releases off the line of scrimmage, his speed and quickness in and out of cuts. He's a very reliable guy with great hands as well as the speed. He really impressed me.
He's now caught a pass in 23 consecutive games. He's 3rd in the nation, by the way, in yards per game. This time they fake the pass and hand it off to Anthony Allen for a very short game. And he's a sophomore from Tampa who's struggled in the last few games to get any. Mario Arruda, number 7 in the ballgame at the bottom of your screen on 2nd and 9. Brown fires to the left and misfires over the head of Douglas.
This is a problem here. Louisville went in, they scouted themselves, they did the self-scout, and when they talked about what was happening on first down, they've been very poor. They have success throwing the ball on the first down, but they can't run it. This series here, this next set of downs here, they had a first down run, no success. Now they're behind schedule. They have to throw the ball.
Here comes the noise on 3rd and 9. Tight end Barnage at the top of the formation. 3 receivers to work with. Allen is the tailback. Pressure from the outside. Brahm steps up complete, but being pulled down short of the first down yardage. Is the ball loose? They're saying no fumble. They'll spot it at the 45, though. Again, a yard short of the first down. JT Thomas on the stop. Second time the Cardinals coming up just a little bit short of that yellow line.
To carry on a little bit about that first down and how important it is to this Louisville football team, when they're scouting themselves at 3rd and 6 or less, they're 50% on third down conversions. When it's 3rd and 9 or more, they're only 27%. You know, I mean, just not being able to convert third downs has been a problem when it's more than 3rd and 6.
Rivers back to receive the Getchy punt. Calls a fair catch at the 22-yard line. No shootout so far. Both defenses doing their job. Still early. Well, the first 3 plays of the game for West Virginia all passes. This will be the first run of the night. White keeps it. Steps up very quickly. Picks up about 4. Lamar Miles on the stop.
Guys, quick. I'm telling you, man, it's a different gear. And Louisville's real challenge is trying to step up quickly and recognize and make the proper adjustments with the angles to the tackle, because you can't simulate it in practice with your scout team.
Well, it's assignment football. You got to be in the right place at the right time, and then you have to make the tackle on guys like White and Slayton in space.
No throw on 2nd and 7. Flip it out in space, and Brandon Hogan, one of the talented newcomers, the freshman, takes it out near the 44 first down as Patino and Earl Heyman, the tackle combo on the defensive lineups.
Starting off with the G unit, we have myself, Earl Heyman.
The PTP are in the linebacker, Lamar Miles. He'll be looking for another great game with double-digit tackles.
Last, we have the duct tape boys, led by corner Rod Council.
We mix it up here at Louisville.
The duct tape boys.
Duct tape boys.
Explain that one. White fires near side. Reynaud makes the catch and makes a man miss. Darius Reynaud across midfield. He's almost the forgotten man. He's been a key guy for 3 years here, number two. 20-yard gain, he shows his speed.
Well, he is a former running back, so this is just an extension of the backfield. And this is what the West Virginia offense does so well. They can hurt you inside and outside with Reynaud in the quick pass.
That was Rod Council, the cornerback here. Faked out of his jock, and now Slayton around the corner. A flag comes down as Slayton breaks into the secondary and down inside the 10. But this one may be coming back. He didn't grab him, is what the you can lip read for Rodriguez. It is a hold, though. And we'll see if he can catch the hold. It nullifies a 35-yard run by Slayton.
Holding, number 62 on the offense. 10-yard penalty from the spot of the foul. Repeat first down.
Junior tackle Ryan Stanchek deemed guilty by the official. Let's see, you can make your own judgment here. To the left side.
Left side, left tackle, gets good body position. All he has to do is drive. I don't think it is. That's a terrible call.
I don't see that as a call there.
That's great footwork by a
excellent
guy
body position.
Stanchek's their best guy up front, and he did an awesome job of getting his body in front of him.
Nevertheless, the second major penalty on the Mountaineers, crucial. First and 20 instead of first and goal inside the 10. Steve Slayton's in the slot for the near side. Some new look. They'll just run it out of this formation. White takes a big hit in the secondary from Palmer. And a good gain on first and 20.
Tackled by Dion Palmer.
It's just not fair. There, Louisville decides, look, we're going to put a safety in the middle now. Yeah, we got burned. A guy missed a tackle on the open field, so we're going to put a guy back there. Now, from a numbers standpoint, with White running the ball, you can block everyone.
Well, this is what's really interesting about this spread offense. When they put Owen Schmidt, that fullback, back there, they can still run the option, but they also have a lead fullback. Now White becomes a tailback following Schmidt in the lane.
Now Schmidt out of the game. Four receivers, and Slayton next to White on second and 11. Hand it off. Slayton breaks a tackle. Shows some strength to go with that speed. Gets down near the 36 before Malik Jackson stops him. There's Jackson, who's had a troubled year. It was a big year last year. Had 9 sacks for this defense. Only has 1 sack this season. One of the reasons why this Louisville defense has struggled is number 11 has struggled. 3rd and 5. White dropped the football as he was going to throw it. Now takes the safe route and falls on it.
Let me tell you why that's a big play for Louisville. The obvious, yes, on the field, but this is a team that traveled 25 players on defense. And so this hot potato that runs through Pat White's hand really helps this defense get off the field, man. They don't have depth out there tonight.
I think it's the other way around. It's a little bit cool out tonight. The ball might feel a little slick on his hand there, and it just slipped right out.
Yeah, but like
cold
said, hands and hot
down
ball.
Down a distance, man. Yeah, that's exactly what happened. They got to make the mistake. West Virginia's going to make the mistake to get themselves off the field. You're not going to stop them.
Made a few mistakes in the early going. A 13-yard loss. Gets the ball back to midfield, and now here's McAfee trying to pin the Cardinals deep. Fair catch made by Trent Guy at about the 15.
Off the field.
Play action fake. Down the middle. Broke it up. Brown was looking for Barnage, the tight end, and a strong play by Eric Wicks dropping into coverage.
The ball just seems to find Wicks. He's got a knack for getting to the ball. He's running with a tight end down the field that Brom says, hey, we got a tight end that can get up the field and make plays for us downfield. Wicks is stride for stride with him.
As Pat White, guys are looking at his hand. The trainers checking things out. Maybe that played a role in him just dropping the ball in that last play. White has been knocked out of some games. Jarrett Brown will be the backup as they hand it off straight ahead. Short gain. Keelan Dykes on the stop. Here's another look at the play, the drop.
All right. I just think it over to his right-hand side. He's trying to rotate the ball to get the seams, and the ball just slides out.
This looks like he maybe hasn't broken a sweat yet to get that grip on the ball.
Let's go to Aaron for more.
Yeah, as you guys can see, they're having Pat White grip the football. But now, interesting enough, early in the season, he was dealing with a thumb injury. His most latest injury, guys, has been that chest and shoulder injury he sustained a couple weeks ago. But Coach Rich Rodriguez said as of yesterday, he was doing fine. So that'll obviously be something we keep an eye on.
Sure will. And third and six, ball pressured and sacked for just the 15th time this season. Zach Cooper, the backup linebacker on the blitz.
That's the key to stopping Brom. They got him off the field last time in a third and long situation with the blitz and forced him to get rid of the ball quickly. This time they get to him with pressure.
I go back to it again. This is all about down and distance for this offense. They're just not comfortable on third down as a whole. And the scouting report came back to them as real as it could be.
0 for 3 on third down tonight, and Getchie again on the punt. And here's Brink pressure. Getchie gets it away. Rivers gambles, catches the ball and gets hammered. He'll lose yardage on the return. And the Mountaineers will start from about their 44-yard line. Defense is doing their job tonight. No points so far in Motown. Four are right here at home. Slayton in the slot for the first time tonight. The Mountaineers start with good field position at their 44. For the first down throw, White fires near side, and catching the ball on the slant is Gonzalez. Tito Gonzalez, just his seventh catch of the season, good for 18 yards.
You know, when you hear coaches around the country say, hey, we'd like to run the wide open, spread open, zone quarterback read, most of them hope they can get a quarterback who can run like White. Then you get a guy that can throw like that.
I mean, that was a legitimate slant route, regular pass play, no read involved there. That was drop back and throw the football.
And right up over the ball, the up-tempo attack that they hope can get the defense on its heels and negate the idea of personnel substitutions. It's Slayton. Steve Slayton turns the corner, makes a move, and has a first down near the 25. Council on the stop, 12 yards.
West Virginia wants to play in space with speed. Defense is spread out and bunched up. Tonight you're going to see a secondary that really is a lot of former offensive guys over there playing defense now, and they're just really trying to adjust to angles.
Slayton in the slot on first down. Cardinals show pressure with three men up the middle. White follows a blocker, turns the corner, and gets down inside the 10. They bring pressure up the middle, and White goes, I'm going around the corner.
Yeah, you bring the safety up into the box. You got everybody up in there saying, we dare you to run the ball. And there goes Schmidt, leading the way for White.
Big guy, Schmidt. It's like the lead fullback to the outside. Find somebody, big fella.
Oh, he couldn't even find anybody to block.
He did at the end. He found the defensive back that was in the wrong spot.
10 yards down the field.
186-pound corner, Johnny Patrick fell the wrath of Owen Schmidt. First and goal. It's Slayton. Slayton, good job with the Cardinal defense. They string him out, dropped for a loss. Malik Jackson.
One of my favorite guys in the country. Fullback, 35, Owen Schmidt. Power cleans 525 pounds, and down the field, he's looking for somebody to put his face mask on.
He's been known to break a few face masks, right?
Yeah, yeah. Including his teammate, the linebacker's nose. Hey, this number up here, that's off the charts.
Can't tell from that picture there, but he's got a mohawk now. So it goes with the attitude, I guess, of being a fullback.
He was downplaying his accomplishments in the weight room, right? He told us, I got one big lift, basically. It's Schmidt next to White on second down. Pat White trying to find room. There isn't much.
Pat White.
Oh, Schmidt, though, his linebacker buddy, Mark Magro, had a meeting with us yesterday. He's got the old busted up nose. And we said, where'd that happen from? He goes, well, I hit Schmidt head on in an ISO deal. My helmet came down and on the bridge of my nose, busted it.
You got to realize they got to go head to head every day in practice. You talk about through training camps and everything else. How many times do you think Schmidt's hit him?
There's
Third and goal from the 7. White still has it. Flips to the end zone. Wide open for a touchdown is Darius Reynaud.
We've been saying how you have to play fast at Louisville tonight. Well, there's two phases to it. You got to play fast and you have to play smart. Pat White with a little lead here coming around to the side. He can run the football. You've got to come up and respect that. You lose secondary coverage.
You know, he had the opportunity. He might have been able to split those defenders to get in the end zone. But you know what? He said, this is just too easy. I'm going to throw it to the back of the end zone and get a touchdown pass. Not my rating.
Yeah, Pat McAfee now 41 of 42 on the year PATs. And Reynaud collects his 9th touchdown reception this season. It's a 56-yard drive in 6 plays. He played pretty good defense throughout the whole first quarter. Played excellent defense on the goal line, but then one little slip up when you saw Deion Palmer, the safety, with Reynaud behind him.
Yeah, you know what, and we kind of hit on this just a little bit earlier, but it's one of those situations where Bobby Petrino, the former coach at Louisville, used to recruit a lot of offensive guys, and if they didn't pan out on offense, they went over to defense. And Krakthorpe's like, look here, man, we got some guys in the secondary that are former offensive guys and aren't really good at coming up and knowing how to tackle.
Oh, that's kind of a problem, isn't it?
The biggest problem is the mentality of wanting to hit and stick your nose in there, especially in the secondary. Guys coming up and trying to tackle these receivers. You know, a lot of arm tackles, grabbing, reaching, bad angles, things that, you know, look like a quarterback chasing a guy on an interception.
And the defensive coordinator not changed. Mike Cassidy has been here, and this is his 4th season. He was the D coordinator under Petrino, stayed under Krakthorpe, but it's been a little bit of a tough year for Cassidy and for his defense for lots of reasons. They had been starting to play much better football the last couple of weeks, giving their offense a chance to win at least.
They're trying to find guys who know how to line up correct. You know, when you see a lot of guys running around right before the snap, and they just haven't been synced up this season.
There's a kickoff by McAfee. It's going to come to Trent Guy near the goal line. He drops it. Guy finds a little crease. A flag is down. There's a battle going on to the 35-yard line. A little bit of a scrum. Easy, fellas. Another flag comes in as this thing threatens to get out of hand. You mentioned there's not a lot of love between these teams. Only the 3rd year in the Big East for Louisville, but it's built up pretty quick.
Yeah, you can't quite call it a rivalry yet.
No.
It's just a grudge match for a little while. But the emotion, I think, is going to help Louisville. I think they've got to come out in this drive, show some toughness, and go after it. Brohm obviously has it on his shoulder to answer that touchdown drive of West Virginia.
We'll sort out the penalties here. First, there was kind of a one-on-one battle between a blocker and a coverage guy at the 35. Then some other guys got involved. There may be 2 fouls here.
During the return, holding number 2 on the return team, 10-yard penalty from the end of the play. After the play was over, personal foul on the receiving team, personal foul on the kicking team. The penalty's offset. It will be first down.
So there were 3 flags. Rich Ragland on the hold, and that'll move things back.
Well, it starts out, looks like it's going to be a disaster. Right in here, here we go. And got your eyes here in the middle.
2-on-1.
Mug. That's a mugging.
Both of them had a hand on his back. Either one of them independently, it's a hold. Collectively, it was a double hold and just a body slam.
Pat Lazier, West Virginia, got double teamed. But the hold sets the Cardinals back at their 15-yard line on 1st and 10. Brohm play action. Looking downfield, down the middle, throws into traffic. There were 4 Mountaineers surrounding Douglas.
You know what, those penalties, Coach Rodriguez, he wants hard, tough playing, but he wants smart playing.
Love to see that. Pull your guys back, get them back under control. That last decision by Brom, by the way, going down the middle of the field was not a great decision.
Calmer approach from Craig Thorpe.
He had a few guys running with the receiver down the field and the safeties over the top. There was not too much of a window to put the ball in there.
Well, Doug, I know he wants to find Douglas, but he's throwing into some traffic. And here's George Stripling getting his turn as a ball carrier. Gets out across the 20. I mean, number 85 has been a productive player, outstanding player, but the Mountaineers are keeping a close eye on him tonight.
You know, Brown went a little play action and wanted to go down the middle, but Wick can run with these receivers. He can come up and play. Wicks comes up to the linebacker position and can run with people down the middle of the field and stay with them.
Manageable down situation in third down. They are, for the season, 50% when it's third and six or less. So this is the situation they want to be in here. Gives them more options.
Haven't converted yet on a third down tonight. 0 for 3. Stripling is the back next to Brown. Good protection. Brown fires to Douglas. The ball's loose. Comes loose. West Virginia jumps on it. Ruled a catch and a fumble. Mountaineer football.
On every third down so far, West Virginia's been bringing pressure, bringing a five, a six-man rush. This time they changed it up.
Well, they changed it up this time here. They come with the outside, and you've got in men coming, and you're going to have three that drop from the middle of the field. So you're getting more folks in the middle of the field to defend the inside route. Great job of Douglas in finding the ball. Just got to hold on to it.
Nice conversion. Tuck it away and get down. Know when your journey is over, Craig. Find the ground.
So West Virginia at the 25-yard line. White takes a deep drop. And he'll throw over the head of Slayton. Slayton working one-on-one against Preston Smith, the linebacker. Well, NASCAR coverage continues next week in Phoenix. NASCAR Busch Series on ESPN2 Saturday at 4 Eastern. And the NASCAR Nextel Cup Series at Phoenix on ABC at 3 o'clock Eastern time. It's getting down to it. Teammates Jeff Gordon and Jimmy Johnson. Johnson jumping ahead of Gordon, leading by 30 points as they head to Phoenix. And it'll all wrap up in Miami. Second and 10 for the Mountaineers. White keeps it. And navigates for a short game. It'll set up about third and six as we head back to the studio for the first time. A 30 at 30 update with Reese Davis.
All right, Chris. One of two memorabilia dealers allegedly robbed by O.J. Simpson testified at a hearing on Thursday that Simpson and several other men burst into a hotel room. One of them had a gun and carried off hundreds of collector's items. This hearing just to determine whether the men will be sent to trial. SportsCenter after the game. Stay current. ESPN News.
Reese, thank you. Third down and six. White fires over the middle. Incomplete. He was looking for Tito Gonzalez. Now a flag comes in. Rod Council got there a little bit early, says the official.
Well, that's from the other side of the field that flag's being thrown from. Kind of makes you wonder how the heck he saw that all the way across.
Really, really makes you wonder. Council broke on the ball. It was bang, bang. It might be interference. It's real close. He reaches around, hits it. I think it's a great play. The flag comes from the opposite corner over here somewhere.
Easy, big fella.
Gonzalez didn't even turn to complain about it, did he?
No.
He wouldn't even think it was interference. Crucial penalty instead of a field goal attempt. Now the Mountaineers set up at first and goal, 9-yard line.
What do you think, big boy? Was that interference?
I didn't like the call.
I formation. That's a rarity for the Mountaineers. Schmidt in front of Steve Slayton. White still has it. Fires. Complete. Touchdown, right on. Number two for number two.
Twice now, the pressure from Pat White on the corner. The threat of running with a fullback in front of him to lead block should he opt for that. has put a lot of pressure on this Louisville defense. And then you got Raynaud, who's a great job at finding the opening. Look at Schmidt,
just
middle
look at
protecting.
The quickness of his release and putting the ball on the money. It's just a great threat, runner throw, on the move, pulling up and throwing.
McAfee makes it 14-0. We're used to seeing the Mountaineers piling up huge rushing totals. Only 42 yards rushing so far in this first quarter, 72 passing.
You know what? The ability for Pat White to see it and immediately let it go. Kind of, you know, one of the trademarks of a Matt Ryan. You know what? Matt Ryan, BC, gets rid of the ball quick. Here they are trying to make sure that they limit this. Rich Rodriguez came from the sidelines as well, and he said, hey, get over here. Let's go. Let's don't get out of control.
That wasn't out of control. Don't get me started, Flutie. I know you're going to say they should throw a flag on everything.
That's right.
Come on.
Sit the ball down.
Fun.
No. Have emotion. Be excited. Jump up and down. Celebrate with your teammates on the way to the sideline. But don't just stand there and parade in the end zone.
Beautiful aerial pictures of this all-gold stadium brought to you by Goodyear. Football's rough. Your commute shouldn't be, so get there on Goodyear Silent Armor Technology. 14 points in a minute 56 for the Mountaineers. The Keelan Dykes recovery of the Douglas fumble sets up a 25-yard three-play drive.
Wasn't it Keelan Dykes who said to us about the emotions of this game and the rivalry and all that stuff? Threw a little jab at Louisville, didn't he?
Yeah.
Bulletin board material.
Be better if they weren't 5-4, he said.
We cracked up, man.
Oh, he's right, though, isn't he? Yeah. I think they wanted Louisville to come in here 9-0. They wanted to have everything on the line as it was last year when the Cardinals got them down to Papa John's. Louisville coming in here as a spoiler. Now you have to wonder. They haven't played bad football on defense, but they find themselves in a 14-zip hole, and Brom hasn't gotten going yet. There's a good look at our man, Schmidt.
Now that's a real mohawk.
It's a real man.
Trent Guy at the goal line. He fights out near the 25 as we get down to Aaron Andrews.
Well, Chris, another guy that had hoped Louisville would come in here 9-0 is, of course, their quarterback, Brian Brohm, returned this season when he could have gone to the NFL. But his head coach, Steve Krapthorpe, said the biggest reason why he will be successful in the league next year is because of all the adversity he's gone through. And he's also been able to accomplish some things, like been able to manufacture some plays. That's something coach said he didn't do last year. Brian told us himself he's making decisions faster. He's getting the ball out quicker. And, you know, I just watched him over here on the sidelines. Very, very calm, making sure Harry Douglas, his wide receiver, is okay. He's really, really poised over here on the sideline.
Now he'll have to be. Louisville, fifth possession already, haven't marched past their own 45. George Stripling, a first down run. Tough one at quarterback when you can't generate much on the ground. Scooter Berry. The stop.
Their running play on first down that is a positive game. Keeps you in down and distance. Pick up 4 yards there, 3 to 4 yards. That's all right. You just can't come up second and 10. Now second and 7, you can manage that situation.
Final minute of the first quarter. Louisville trying to answer. Hard part about getting into a deficit against the Mountaineers, you got to break serve against their offense to try to get back in the game. Barnage, the tight end, collects it out across the 45. Hangs on, a big hit delivered there by Antonio Lewis.
But you know what, Doug, going back to what Steve Krapthorpe said about Brian Brohm and being able to go into a locker room in the NFL, you don't win all the time in the NFL. And so you got to know how to handle adversity and to pick up the team around you.
Especially when you're a top draft choice. You're going to the teams that are picking first or second. Unless a great team happens to trade up and needs a quarterback for some reason, chances are you're going to a team that's not going to win right away, and you're going to have to learn to deal with that.
Let's talk more about potential draft prospects for Brohm as the night unfolds. In the meantime, on first down, stop for a loss is Stripling. That try a little wrinkle there, and the Mountaineer defense just storms in there. There's our guy Magro, the hometown Morgantown hero. The guy who grew up going to these football games, not watching them necessarily, playing football outside, and then going down and begging for players' gloves after the game.
He's the one that has the bridge of his nose busted up because of Schmidt, you know?
Well, so far it's the Cardinals getting busted up in Motown, 14-0 for the all gold clad guys after the first.